All right, folks, Johnathan here. We're going to take a look at the SDJ1 from American Audio. First of all, it's not a CD player, it's not a vinyl turntable, and it is definitely not an amphibious landing craft, but it does play music. You've got one entity here and one entity here. In the middle, you've got two slots where you will actually house the SD memory cards. Now, each slot, you can put a memory card up to a maximum of 4 gigabytes. Now, I'm no expert, 4 and 4 is 8, that's 8 gigabytes. So I would say, give or take, you're looking at maybe 1500 songs, MP3 files, that you can put into this one unit. Now what you do, I can't take these out at the moment because the actual unit's on, but it comes with that. Now what that does, that will plug into your USB port into your PC. What you do is you transfer your files through this onto your SD card, you take the SD card out, you bung it in there, and bingo, you've got all your music ready to rock and roll. So what I'll do, we'll pause the camera and we'll actually have a closer look at this particular unit. Then I'll do a little bit of a mix, and then after that, I'll tell you what I think. Hold tight. All right, we'll have a sort of a general idea of what this guy is all about. Now we've got here, this is the jog wheel. Basically, it works near enough exactly the same as a normal jog wheel on a CDJ. You've got cue, you've got play, pause, in, out, and reloop, so you can actually loop the music as well. Now here, you can see card select. Now basically what that means is, for example, this card here, say, will work this side. If we press that button, then that card will work that side. And we can swap them over, so you don't have to have that card on that side. This dial here is basically for track search and also folder search. You've got tap BPM. You've got here a button with ADV track. Now basically what that means is, let's say for example you've got a track playing. What you can do, you can press that and you can search through the card. You can select the next track to play and then you can play it. You've got search, forward or back, pitch bend, which is exactly the same as a normal other CD player. That's your pitch adjustment. You've got actual tempo lock. And the pitch range is 16, 8 and 4. Now I say this when I can remember with virtually every single video when I look at the pitch control. If you are a keen mixing DJ, for goodness sake, don't go to plus or minus 16. The reason being, you've got less control over that pitch. Put it this way, if you're on plus or minus 16, your movements are going to be really, really fine to try and get it perfectly in beat. If you're on plus or minus 4 or 8, then you've got more movement and you're in more control. Very, very important. Right, what I'll do now, I'll pause the camera and we'll just have a tiny bit of a mix. Hold tight. All right, here we go. I'm just going to mix a couple of tracks. So if you want the actual track names, just look to the side of the video. And I'm not going to wear any headphones. So the whole idea is just so I can get an actual feel of what the pitch is like. So here we go. Well, the cue's quite responsive, you know, you press the cue and if the track you're playing starts off with that first beat, then it does come in. Let's get them all off. All over the place. Alright, first of all, if you're watching this particular video around about February 2008, if you go to www.djtutor.com, one of these is up for grabs. Just go to the competition page. Alright, what do I think of it? Alright, I like vinyl turntables. I like CDJs. It could take me a little bit of a time to, you know, a little bit of time to get actually used to this piece of kit, but it does serve a purpose. I mean, here's an example. Let's say you're a mobile DJ and, for example, you know, someone's booked you to do a wedding or someone's booked you to do a 21st birthday party. Now, occasionally what they'll do is they'll email you a playlist of their favourite tracks. And if you're like me and you've just got a whole load of CDs, you're normally sifting through these CDs and you're writing down, you know, now 27 track 3, or, you know, Tina Turner, Simply the Best, it's in that corner in that particular box. Excuse me. Well, you see, what you could do is you could basically get all of your tracks in a folder on your actual PC, and then you could wang it onto a card, put your card in here, or two cards, and theoretically then, the entire playlist that they've asked you to play is in here. So, admittedly, you could still take your two CDJs or your vinyl turntables and something like that. So you've got all of the music that people have requested in the one little unit and you haven't got to worry about it. Plus the fact, if you're concerned about people nicking your CDs, theoretically, because you can get so many tracks onto this, there's no real need to take your CDs with you because everything is there on two small little cards. So there you go, a quick look at the SDJ1 from American Audio. Practice and enjoy.